हॅलो स्टुडंट्स, मायसेल्फ सिद्धेश्वर बी तुळजापुरे, असोसिएट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मेकॅनिकल इंजिनिअरिंग, वालचंद इन्स्टिट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नॉलॉजी, सोलापूर. सो इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डील विथ सिंक्रोनायझिंग सर्किट. द लर्निंग आउटकम: ॲट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन स्टुडंट्स विल बी एबल टू ड्रॉ सिंक्रोनायझिंग सर्किट अँड एक्सप्लेन इट्स वर्किंग. The contents are: firstly, we will have introduction, then we will go for different methods of obtaining synchronization, then synchronizing circuit, and lastly the references. Let us first start with the word it is synchronization. What synchronization means? So when we are having the word synchronization, so more than one operation or activity, these are going to come into picture. So synchronization refers to the operation or activity of two or more things at the same time or at the same rate it is. So we are having two, that is at the same time or at the same rate it is. Say two or more operations we are having, or two or more activities we are having. Next to that one, the need of synchronization in case of the hydraulic actuators may be due to different reasons. One of them, say, for example, if we take for the clamping operation, suppose we are making use of the two cylinders for the more forces, and say more force for the clamping, these two pistons of the two linear actuators, they should move with the, say, in a synchronized fashion. So one should not move ahead and one should not be on the, say it is following the first one. So like that it should not be. So in case of that one, or any other specific process requirements we may have, where even not two, we can have even more number of the actuators, and they are having the, say, the pistons of those should move in the synchronized fashion. So like that we may have certain process requirements, etc. So in case of those, so how that synchronization can be achieved, so that we can think of. Now presently consider just simple, say, two linear actuators we have gone for, and then the, say, 4x2 direction control valve we are having. Say P is connected to A, supply to the two cap ends, it is at the same time, pistons of these two, they are going to move, and the oil from the rod end side, again it is coming through the common pipe to the, say, port B, and B is connected to T. Now what you have to think of is whether the movements of the two linear actuators are synchronized or not. That is, the pistons of these two cylinders, whether they are going to move at the same time with the same, say, rate of movement. So that at any time, if we check the position of this one and this one, the both are going to be exactly at the same position. Suppose at the middle, and if we take the time for that middle position, the time should be required, it is same, etc. So like that you can think of. So the synchronized movement, it whether we are going to get with the help of this arrangement or not, that you have to think of. See, supply to both the cylinders cap end at the same time, and the oil returning from the rod end, it is taken to the port B through a common pipe just after some initial connections. Supply is also through common pipe, but later on slight, say, connections, these are going to be to the two cylinders or two cap ends. See, the answer is no actually. See what happens. There are number of factors which are controlling the movement of the actuators, or the, say, the pistons in case of these linear actuators. Now we are having one, it is the pipe length. Say the common pipe, it is okay, but from there one pipe goes to the cap end of the one cylinder and another goes to the cap end of the another cylinder. So the length of these, it is going to matter. The friction of oil and, say, the inner surface of the pipe, it is going to matter. Friction between the oil and the inner surface of the cylinders, it is going to matter, because two cylinders are there again. And unequal flow, to some extent, it may also be there. So exactly 50-50% of the oil will not go to the two cylinders. In case of that one also, the difference it is going to occur. So one piston it is capable of moving ahead and the second one it is going to follow to some extent. So like that the things are going to be. So these are not the synchronized movements actually. So what we can have is different methods can be used for the synchronization. So one of the methods it is, say, mechanical clamping. The second one is also referring to the, say, mechanical coupling, first one. And the second one, it refers to the, say, mechanical means only, but with the help of the rack and pinion arrangement. Third one, it is actually, you can call it as a synchronization circuit or synchronizing circuit. So it is by making use of the flow divider it is. One by one, we are going to deal with. Say the first one we will consider. So it is the synchronizing circuit by making use of the mechanical coupling. See what we have done. We have, say, taken the, say, end of this first piston rod and the end of this second piston rod to the one plate which is fixed here to these two piston rods by some, say, screw and nut, etc. So you are having these two piston rods fixed to a single plate. Means, even though number of factors are there which are leading to the difference in the piston positions or the speed of the piston positions, speed of the pistons, etc. So what is happening is, if the one piston is moving, so it is taking along with this plate, and this plate is again fixed to the another piston rod end. So the second piston is also going to move. So like that, so we are having the mechanical coupling between the two piston rods and the two pistons. These are piston movements. These are now in a synchronized fashion. So this is the simplest type we are having. This is a low cost system, but we have no changes in the, say, earlier simple circuit which we dealt, say, and the, say, synchronization was not there. Just what we have done is we have used some mechanical means for that synchronization. So that is what we have done here. Next, the precise movement if you are needed, or precise synchronization if it is needed, what further you can do is, we can go for, instead of that plate which is attached at the end of the piston rod, say you can go for the rack and pinion arrangement. So one piston, so it is at the end of this, we are going to have the rack. So this rack is meshing with one pinion. Pinion is mounted on a shaft. On the same shaft, we are having one more pinion, and this pinion is meshing with the rack which is attached to the end of the another piston rod. So we are having the pinion specification same, the rack specification same. So here what will happen is, if one piston is moving ahead, so the sequence how it is taking place, the motion of one rack it is going to take place, then the corresponding meshed pinion it is going to rotate. The pinion is mounted on the shaft, so shaft is going to rotate. The shaft will give motion to that second pinion also, so because it is mounted on that one. So that pinion gives lastly the motion to the rack. So second rack is also moving. You can observe that it was started with the first rack and it has ended with the second rack. So we are having both the racks moving at the same time. So that is what the synchronization we have achieved using the rack and pinion. The last one it is, you can say, actually call it as a synchronization circuit, because here mechanical means we are not using, and we are going to make use of the some valves which say it is called as flow divider. Now see here, we are having that 4x3 direction control valve here. The middle position of the spool we have shown here. Then we are going for the common pipe or the common working line. From here it goes to this flow divider, or you can say it is, say, together flow divider, it is flow control valve. Through this one it is going to the, say, cap end of one cylinder, and through this one it is going to the second cylinder. So now we might have some differences in the resisting loads here and here. Say one is doing the, say, one operation and the second one is doing another operation. You can consider the different operations which are occurring in the industries. Say now these two may be totally different operations and the resisting loads may be totally different. So in those situations, what might happen is, if the load resistance it is more here or here it is, say where the resistance it is lesser, that piston it is going to move faster. So that is what is going to happen if we are restricting ourselves to the use of this one only, that is these flow control valves. Because the flow control valve, so it is not pressure compensated here, and we are having the flow through this one based on the pressure difference and between the inlet and the outlet, and the pressure difference across this flow control valve, it is dependent upon the resisting load, that is what we are having. Now here what you can do is, you can go for the use of the check valves here. So the check valves here and here you can observe, and we are going to have the use of the two check valves here. So these two check valves will allow us to have the movement of the these two pistons independent of the resisting loads, and the excess flow from one of the say cylinders where the resisting load is lesser will be diverted to the second cylinder, and the second cylinder it is going to move in a synchronized fashion with the first cylinder. So like that, what we are having is, with the help of the flow divider, we are having the synchronization of the two pistons. So three different say synchronization methods we have seen. Firstly by mechanical coupling, the second one was also mechanical, that is by making use of the rack and pinion type of the arrangement, and the third one is actually the synchronization circuit where we have gone for the use of the flow divider. It is so, we'll stop here. These are the references. Thank you.